Hello everyone, in this video we'll be looking at STL, that is the Standard Template Library, and how to use STL in competitive programming. So before beginning with anything, I would just like to say that STL is the best thing that C++ has to offer, and if you are not using it, you are missing out on a lot. So let's begin and let's explore what is STL. So normally we have any kind of storage, let's say arrays, and we have functions that manipulate the data in present inside the storage. So here in STL we'll call them as containers, and we have algorithms which act as functions, but here they don't interact directly. So instead we have iterators which help the algorithms manipulate the content present inside these containers. So that is the basic structure of STL. Let's look at what type of containers does STL offer. The first type is sequence containers, which is very obvious by the name, that it stores data in a sequential format. Vectors, list and dq fall under this category. Associative containers store the data in a key value format. So map, multi-map, set and multi-set, these four fall under this category. So we'll be looking at all of these containers in the upcoming videos in our playlist, but for now, for the first video, we'll be looking at the very first container called as vectors. So let's begin. So let's begin with the actual C++ programming of vectors. So as you can see, I have included the vector header file over here, and let's go ahead and create our first vector. So the way to create vectors is pretty simple, by using the vector keyword, specifying the data type inside the angular brackets and giving a name to your vector. So now we have successfully initialized our vector, and we don't have any elements inside the vector. So the size for this vector should be 0. So this v.size function returns the size of the vector. So here in the output section we can see 0, because we have no elements inside our vector. Now if you want to insert an element inside the vector, we will use the pushback function. The pushback function is used to insert the element inside the vector at the end. So pushback function, insert the element at the end. So we'll insert 10, 20, 30 and 40. And now let's look at the size of the vector. So you can see 4 after here. So let's make it a bit tidy. Yeah, the first is 0, then you inserted 4 elements, and then you have the size of the vector is 4. So this is pushback function, and we can also print out the capacity of the vector. Capacity of the vector is the capacity of the vector to contain that many number of elements. So for example, for now, the capacity of a vector is it's 4 over here. The capacity of that vector is 4 right now. Now if I insert one more, since we have 4 elements, the capacity is 4. Now if I insert one more element over here, let's suppose say 50, and now let's have a look at the size and the capacity of this vector. So the capacity was 4, and when we inserted one more element, we have the size as 5, which is obvious. But the capacity doubled, and this is because of the ability to resize, that is dynamically. So the vector resizes itself to contain more and more number of elements at the same time. So that is about inserting the element, the size of the element. Now if you want to print the elements of the vector, you have to traverse through a vector just like you used to do for an array. So here, instead of int I, we'll take auto it v dot begin it not equal to v dot end and it plus plus. So your it is the iterators that we talked about before, and iterators the first iterator is pointing to the beginning of the vector, and it will go till it is not equal to the end of the vector. So this begin and end are the inbuilt functions of the vector class, and we are incrementing the iterator over here. Now iterator, since iterator is a reference, that is it points to the location of that vector, it does not point to the element value directly, but it points to the address of that element. So hence we are using a star operator here, an asterisk, to print the value of the elements present in the vector. So let's see the elements present inside the vector. So here you can see 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So these 5 elements are printed from the vector. So that is this was pretty simple. Auto it v equal to v dot begin, it not equal to v dot end, and it plus plus. So this iterator was used to traverse to the vector, and it's pretty simple. Now this pushback function is used to insert an element at the end. So what if you want to delete the last element? That is done by using the popback function. Now popback function deletes the element from the last, like the last most element. So now if you print the elements of the vector, the last element will be missing. So let's just print here deleted the last element. And let's just go ahead. Deleted the last element and 10, 20, 30, 40. So 50 was deleted by popback function. So we deleted the last element. And now let's go ahead with inserting an element at some position. So pushback element was used to insert an element at the end. Now what if you want to insert an element at some position P? So we'll do it by using an insert function. So v.insert, and inside it we pass the position to where you want to insert an element. So suppose v.begin plus P, whatever the position is, and the element which I want to insert. So suppose let's say I want to insert 25 in between 20 and 30. So I'll insert 25 over here, and v dot begin plus 2, because v dot begin is 10, 10 plus 1 is 20, and plus 2 will be the position where I'll be inserting 25. So let's just print a message and print all the elements of the vector again. So we'll print over here added 25. So let's just go ahead. So yeah, as you can see, I've added 10, 20, 25 in between 20 and 30. So that is how you insert an element in at a position P, at a particular position. Now suppose if you want to erase some element, that is if you want to erase some element at some position. Now because popback is also used to delete only the last element, we have inserted an element at a particular position P, we should be able to delete that element at that particular position. So inside erase as well, we'll pass the position in this format v.begin plus to which. Now let's delete 25 again. Let's remove that oddity. And we have, okay, no, we don't need to pass the element, but okay, begin plus 2. At this position, we should be able to erase the element. So let's just print a message again. Deleted 25. And here we go. So yeah, again we deleted the element at position we begin plus 2, that was 25. So that was about inserting, erasing, printing, and checking the size and capacity of a vector. Now, if I want to insert some more elements, let's say I have inserted more elements over here, some random numbers, some huge numbers, and suppose 1, and in any random order. But now I want my vector to be sorted, that is in a sorted order. So C++ has an algorithm library which we will include over here and apply that algorithm to our vector to sort it. So these sorting algorithms are highly optimized. So I've included the algorithm header library over here, and I'll use the sort function to sort my vector. So sort, inside this you will pass the beginning of the vector again. So vector.begin, comma, the end of the vector, that is the last element till which we want to sort. So this is it, v.begin, v.end. Pass it inside the sort function and you have printed your sorted array. So let's just copy this, and so here we'll print we have sorted our array. And let's print. Sorry, let's look at the output. So since we added, deleted, yeah. So here we have the sorted arrangement of all these elements: 10, 1, 10, 20, 4, 7, 2, 4, 9, 8, 9, 9. So that is how we sort a vector using a very simple, sweet sort function. Similarly, we can have a function to reverse a vector. So all this is a part of the algorithm library that we have included later. So similarly, we can just call the reverse function, pass in the beginning of the vector, the ending of the vector, and print the vector. So let's see. So here we have the output. We had sorted it and now it's reversed, like from the greatest number to the smallest number. So these are reverse and sort are a part of the algorithm library, and there are a lot of functions that you can actually apply on these vectors and manipulate the data inside these containers through these algorithms. So that is the basics of vectors, and hope you enjoyed and practice more. Thank you.